Hello YouTube, this is Kurosama, and here we're happy today is once again the Gundam 00 Sky. Now this is actually the higher than sky phase. So the only big difference between this kit and the one I reviewed earlier is going to be the effect parts, the overall color scheme of the plastic, as well as it comes with a stand. That's something that I really always wanted, I think every kit should come with a stand, but if they did that, then obviously their stands that they sell externally, they would probably diminish. But other than that, I really am enjoying the overall aesthetics of this kit. I think it looks phenomenal. I love the effect parts. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take a closer look at the box. So this was released in 2018, retails for 2,200 yen. And one thing you will notice is that they're both labeled number 14 and the Build Divers line, except for this one is special. I'm just kind of assuming that's what the SP is for, so it's more of a special edition. And as we see here in the box, you definitely get all these nice little accessories, so all the effect parts for the wings, as well as the stuff for the bracers. And you're also going to get that nice, pretty sure it's the Stage 5, I think it's like the Stage 5 stand. So it's pretty nice that it's going to be included with this. And over here, it's just kind of showing you all the different accessories that it's going to come with. So obviously, you're going to get the Buster Sword. You are going to get the Beam Rifle and then the Long Rifle with the little Beam Sabers. So that's all amazing. And you're going to get the Last Position once again. Over here, it's just kind of showing you the lineup of all the Build Divers kits. And then you get a front and rear shot of the kit as well as some description right there. And as you can see right here, we are going to get a few bags of basically all the different accessories and everything. But the major differences is going to be these two bags, which is going to be the effect parts as well as the stand. So we'll take a look at Runner A. Basically, it's all going to be the same. This whole runner does not look any different. It's going to have all the same clear parts right here and all the same gray inner frame like so. Now, Runner B, on the other hand, this is going to be very, very sky blue. I know, all puns intended, but very, very sky blue. And then the red is actually kind of replaced with a pink. That's the way I'm kind of like looking at it, almost like a fluorescent pink. And then right here is definitely going to be a fluorescent yellow. So this is going to be super, super cool to have on a shelf because it's just going to stick out like a sore thumb. And next we're going to get Runner C, which is going to be this nice pearlescent, pretty much a pearlescent white. So I'm all about pearlescent colors, and I think some people probably don't enjoy it, but I do think that, you know, some of it can actually look pretty good, just really depending on the kit that it actually is being utilized on. But there's a lot of kits I would love to go ahead and spray paint a pearlescent white on. And then next we're going to have Runner D, which once again is not really going to be any different. It's going to be like the same gray. It may be a little bit more glossy. Can't really tell, to be honest, but I think it's just going to be the exact same runner without any kind of added like gloss or features to it. Now we are going to have the new green runner, which is going to be exclusively for that front crest part, and the color is just going to be a little bit brighter than the previous one, so not really too much of a change, but you are going to have a brighter clear green part. And you're going to have the two clear effect parts, basically it's going to be for the Buster Sword as well as for the Beam Sabers. Same old polycap sheet, same sticker sheet. And now we look at the runners that are basically going to be the main focus of this kit. So they look really, really nice. They're a little bit tough, to be honest. So not really too bad. And they're going to have this nice little kind of like sparkle effects on the inside of this. So that looks super, super awesome. Really, really excited to go ahead and put all this on the kit because this may take my level of appreciation of this kit to another level. I don't know. I'm a sucker for effect parts, especially when it comes to like the Destiny or just most of the Seed kits. I think their effect parts look phenomenal. So this is definitely going to be looking really, really good on the shelf. And lastly, for the runners, basically you can get this nice little stand right here. And lastly, for the runners, you're basically going to have this number 5 stand. So a lot of different options right here. So basically posing it on the runner is going to have a lot of different customizable options, but I'm probably just going to stick to more of the basic stuff. But overall, hey, you got a nice little clear, almost like pretty much gold, yellow, I would say mostly gold stand. So this is fairly unique and definitely don't have anything of this kind of color. Now, there's not really too much to look in the manual. It's all very basic and cookie cutter. It's essentially the same. I think this side right here is just going to have all the new stuff. So this is going to start showing you the construction of the actual stand itself. And then, basically the stand's going to be right there. And one of these pages should have, there we go, the effect parts right there. But everything else is going to be essentially the same as the manual itself. And even the color of the mobile suit pretty much looks the same. It doesn't look like it's the brighter blue. It looks like it's almost the same blue, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong, though. But yeah, it looks pretty darn good, to be honest. So this is going to be the final product, and I will be super, super stoked to go ahead and finally build this. But other than that, guys, definitely let me know what your thoughts are on this kit. If you've already built it, let me know. If not, then let me know if you're going to go ahead and buy it, or if you're pretty much waiting for people to post up their reviews. So that way you can make your judgment call. I know that's what I normally do whenever it came to me being back in the States. I always kind of waited for some of the reviews to come out, because not necessarily if I'm going to buy it or not, but I kind of want to make judgment calls on if I'm going to have to buy certain paints or not, because a lot of those promotional pictures do not show the entirety of what needs to be painted. So other than that, though, this definitely looks like a great kit, and I'm pretty stoked to go ahead and build it once again. But other than that, guys, thanks for watching. Please rate, comment, subscribe like always. And if you have any kind of comments, please share them in the comment section below so I can go ahead and read them and reply to you. But other than that, guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the review. Bye-bye.